This table was the site of Ida's endless bickering. After I told Ida about my relocation plans, I was lucky this knife didn't end up in my ribs. I know this sound. It's a baby monitor. We bought one when Stella was born. Ugh, locked. How convenient. What was that? Doorbell seems broken. Huh, nothing happened. Nothing happened. The clock is louder here. I see. The metal strip's broken. I need some way to close the circuit. Anyone home? Ida?
I am not taking any more of your crap. You can fucking shove it!
And what about her?
You know, she has a name. Stella only runs away from you. Not once, not twice, every fucking time. I'd say it's pretty easy to tell who she doesn't want to live with.
Really? Well, I bet your piece of shit boyfriend is who she's actually running from.
Unlike you, he is actually worth something.
His money is the only thing that grabbed your attention. And you knew just what to trade for it. Always the same with you.
Maybe I am just tired of living a crappy life with an asshole who cares about nothing but himself.
So you kicked me out and let a loaded pedophile in. You were always so damn stupid.
One more word about him and this discussion is over. Permanently.
It's always so much fun watching people hurting each other. It's hard to come up with a really good insult. Although, truth be told, yours were so pathetic. Maybe this time Ida finally surprised you. Poof. Your perfectly planned little world goes up in flames.
It was that lawyer. If he...
Oh, are we lying again, Daniel? Don't forget. The first time Stella ran away was purely because of you.
Yeah. And it's also me looking for her in this hellhole. While those two are drinking their overpriced wine, totally oblivious to the fact that she's missing.
Is that so? Then go home. You don't have to be here.
I don't think this trip came with a return ticket, and I'm finally starting to understand why I deserve all this.
Aw, poor little Daniel. You know what? You're boring. Come back when you're more fun.
I spent way too much time in here, preparing all the camp games. This TV was always on. I never understood what was so interesting. But even when no one was watching and I turned it off, Ida would always come in and turn it back on. Just more senseless noise in our broken relationship. Nothing happened. Nothing happened. Thank you.
Do you even care how expensive those were? Do you think I just shit money?
I'm sorry, Daddy. I just tripped. I didn't mean to.
Tripped? How about you try to be, at least once in your life, useful? Everything you ever touch breaks or spills or...
So what happened, Daniel? Did your little Stella kill someone?
I don't remember. I don't even understand why you want me to see this.
Let me refresh your memory. On that very day, two wine glasses silently stood on the table. You might even remember when Ida brought them home from IKEA. When Stella tripped, those glasses, which must have been oh so expensive, fell down to the ground and shattered.
And?
You sent her to bed. And I am sure you want to know what happened next. Daddy, please don't do that!
Why not? Maybe now you'll learn what losing something important feels like.
And it's the only thing Grandma left me. Take all my toys, just please. Please don't take my doll.
Not gonna happen. This is the only way to teach you.
So you took the doll, went outside, tore it up, and threw it into the trash. You must have been really happy with yourself. I bet little Stella finally understood how to appreciate things, right? And that's all for now. Ta!
This girlish stuff was more Ida than Stella. Ida always tried to project her failed dreams into Stella's room, the result being this inconsistent mess of cheap IKEA furniture. I remember how happy Stella was when she got this uniform for the first time. Those were good days. I can hear the clock clearly. I can hear the clock clearly.
Just
have you done to my daughter? You can kill me, but please, let her go. So, this is it. I'm finally dead, right? Took him quite a few tries to get me.
Tell me, Daniel, how have you found Stella?
Stella? Oh, right. My daughter. I went to the woods looking for her. It was such a long time ago.
And have you found her?
I don't think so. It was Leah. This little girl. Or was she a doll called Rosie? I don't know. Maybe she was Stella, and I just didn't recognize her. And that woman, Eleonora, something got to her. And she jumped off the cliff. Or maybe she was just another figment of my imagination.
Look into your heart. Do you think she was real?
I wish she was. But somehow, nobody I've met in these woods feels real. And that includes you.
And you, Daniel, are you real?
Yeah. It doesn't matter now, does it? At least I no longer need to fight for my life.
Your story is not over yet. You will return one more time. It's up to you what you do with your last chance. Be careful. The beast is closer to you than you think. And that's what really keeps you from finding your daughter.
I really didn't want to return here. She should have let me die in peace.
So, are you awake or not? Come here right now, boy.
Kill me now.